This video was made possible by CuriosityStream. When you sign up for an annual subscription at curiositystream.com/HAI, you'll also get access to Nebula, where you can watch HAI videos early and ad-free. The great philosopher Theophrastus once said, "Time is the most valuable thing a man can spend." Theophrastus, of course, was an idiot and had forgotten about Kohl's cash. You try buying khakis with time and see how it goes. But Kohl's cash has a problem. It's dropping in value because it's only good for a certain number of days, and since 2011, days have gotten shorter. You see, back in 2011, LMFAO released the hit song Party Rock Anthem, which called on everyone to party rock, to have a good time, and most importantly, to shake that. Unfortunately, it turned out the Earth loved Party Rock Anthem too, and when told to shake that, took the instructions literally and caused an earthquake in Japan. In addition to being the costliest natural disaster in history, the World Bank estimated the damage at $235 billion, the 9.0 magnitude Tohoku earthquake also did a bunch of crazy stuff to the Earth. It cracked the seafloor, it broke icebergs and sped up glaciers 8,000 miles away in Antarctica, it reduced the gravity in Japan by thinning the Earth's crust, and finally, it even shortened the length of a day, something that usually only happens once a year as part of a deep state conspiracy to mess up my sleep schedule called daylight saving time. To understand how an earthquake managed to steal away your precious hours of shut-eye, you first have to understand something called the moment of inertia, which sounds like a Coldplay album from the late 2000s, but is actually a physics term for the torque needed for a desired angular acceleration around a rotational axis, which is basically fancy talk for how hard it is to make a round thingy go spin. When the earthquake quakes the Earth and all, it redistributed mass closer to the Earth's core, which decreased the Earth's moment of inertia. To help illustrate, picture a figure skater pulling their arms close to their body to speed up their rotation. In the same way the figure skater spins faster when they pull their arms closer to their body, the Earth spins faster when an earthquake pulls mass closer to its center. Of course, this paragraph might have sounded similar to one 139 HI episodes ago, but we'll ignore that. As a result, days are now 1.8 microseconds shorter. A microsecond, by the way, is 1/1000th of a second. For perspective, 1 microsecond is how long it takes for light to travel 300 meters. For another perspective, 1 microsecond is how much time I spent trying to think of a joke to put here before I gave up and moved on. So 1.8 microseconds isn't really that much, and actually, it's natural for the length of day to vary. In a normal year, it can fluctuate as much as 0.38 milliseconds, mostly due to changes in atmospheric winds. While slight changes in the Earth's rotation speed are pretty common, the 2011 earthquake had another, more unusual consequence. It shifted the Earth's axis. To understand how it did that, we have to talk about a bunch of space and physics and geophysics stuff, which is going to be confusing enough on its own, so for now we're going to take all the jokes and put them in a little box that we'll keep in the corner of the screen, and once we're done explaining, we'll open it. Okay, so the Earth rotates around what's called a rotational axis, which is an imaginary line that runs through the North and South Pole. If you picture spinning a globe, the little rod it spins around is the rotational axis, and the earthquake didn't change that. The rotation axis can only be shifted by something in space, like the moon or the sun or whatever. But the Earth isn't balanced along the rotation axis. It's balanced along something called the figure axis, which is an imaginary line that's usually located about 10 meters from the north-south rotation axis. In theory, if the Earth were a perfect sphere, the figure axis and the rotation axis would be the same line, and the Earth would spin smoothly, but the Earth isn't a perfect sphere. There's a bunch of stuff like glaciers and water sloshing around and changing atmospheric pressure, and also something called the Ice Age rebound, and the result of all of those things is that when the Earth spins, it wobbles a little bit, and the earthquake seems to have made that wobble worse by moving the figure axis about 6.5 inches further from the rotation axis. Okay, now we'll let out all the jokes. Let's see what I missed. Ice Age Rebound sounds like a DreamWorks movie, Drake meme about the axes, there's a dance called The Wobble, could have worked that in. Alright, doesn't seem like there's anything too important. Let's keep going. Now, you might be thinking, so what? The Earth wobbles a little more now. Who cares? Well, first of all, I care. I made a whole video about it, so show some respect. Second of all, this stock footage bear cares. I paid for the stock footage, so I get to decide what he cares about, and I've decided he cares about Earth wobbling. And finally, the Earth's wobble matters a lot for NASA and other space agencies. They have to account for the wobble when spacecraft plan their flight paths, because if they miscalculate the Earth's rotation at launch, they could end up miles away from their intended destination. But hey, if there's one thing history has taught us, it's that when explorers accidentally end up in the wrong place, it turns out great for everyone involved. Nobody ever gets enslaved, and the explorer who enslaved people definitely doesn't get a holiday named after them. If you were enjoying a poorly conceived holiday and needed something to watch, you might think, hey, I sure do wish all my favorite educational creators had gotten together to create a streaming service where they're able to make cool, fresh, and sometimes exclusive content without worrying about demonetization or algorithms. Well, guess what? Your weirdly specific wish came true. It's called Nebula, and it's got all our YouTube content, ad-free and early, plus exclusive Nebula originals from HEI, from Wendover, even from people like Tom Scott, who made an incredible backstabbing game show called Money that I got to be a part of. The best way to get Nebula is through a bundle deal with CuriosityStream, the fantastic documentary streaming service with thousands of great titles, including originals from people like David Attenborough and Jane Goodall. On there, you could even watch Saving Tokyo, which is about the massive infrastructure projects they're conducting to protect the city from earthquakes just like the one we discussed. Right now, for less than $15, you can get an entire year of CuriosityStream and Nebula when you go to curiositystream.com/HAI, and you'll be supporting the channel while you're at it.